Hey everyone, Horseman here, and today I'm going to bring to you part 5 of the Necromancer beta, and this video is going to be focusing on two separate things, actually. The first one is going to be showing you guys my melee build. I am level 70 right now, and I'm currently doing Torment 3. I just wanted to show you guys real quick how to incorporate Army of the Dead somewhat efficiently. Again, there's no sets yet, and so we don't know exactly what the sets are going to involve, what abilities are going to involve, so I can't gear towards anything towards that right now. All I can do is try to get my gear the best that I can towards, you know, what I'm somewhat shooting for. Hence the Blackthorns that I'm rolling with right now in order to get some of that extra bonuses towards elites. And I also wanted to get as much cooldown as I could because of the fact that Army of the Dead is a 2-minute cooldown. In prior testing, I didn't see the benefit to using Army of the Dead or Land of the Dead, so I decided that I wanted to do some testing to see if I could make a build that was viable with this. And this is what I came up with. The first thing I wanted to get is Grim Scythe, Cursed Scythe. The Grim Scythe is a 180-degree melee strike. It's a cleave. Summons a scythe in it, and it does that. It does actually some decent damage, so I thought it would be really fun to use. Cursed Scythe. Enemies have a chance to be inflicted with a random curse. I thought that was very interesting. The curses that we have available to us, as I have shown in other videos as well, are Decrepified, Leech, and Frailty. Right now, and I think it's going to get nerfed quite a bit, is that Frailty is a crippling curse that instantly kills enemies at low health. Now, in the past, it used to say 15%. So now, I guess they must have updated it. I mean, this is just as of yesterday. I'm not sure exactly what that threshold is anymore. Now, the reason why this is important is because in some testing that I was doing, with this particular build, I was doing up to 4.4 trillion damage, because 15% is a big chunk, especially when you think about Grift Guardians, as well as other elites and champ packs. That 15% would be quite a big amount of health that they would have to suddenly make disappear. So that's kind of what I'm going with here, and that's why that Cursed Scythe is there. But in order to make it a little bit more efficient, I'm also taking Eternal Torment, which means that the curses cost 50% less, and though that's not going to affect the Cursed Scythe, what is that it will last forever. That means when I apply that curse on an enemy, it's not going away. And that's the important part of all of this. Okay. So the next, my spender is going to be Death Nova. Because this is a melee class, I want to make sure that I have stuff nearby. I'm going to be in the middle of it all. And so I chose Death Nova. And in particular, I chose the Tendril Nova, which releases a Nova of tendrils that damage all nearby enemies and heals you for each enemy hit. And I do feel it's important to make sure that I get the health back whenever I'm doing these attacks. I'm going to be in the middle of it all. I'm going to be getting hit. So rather than relying on potion, or not potion, but my the health globes, or relying on the cooldown of my potion, I want to make sure that I have some type of ability that's going to also replenish that, since I can. Army of the Dead summons a massive army of death to pummel the targeted location. The skeletal army knocks all affected enemies towards the center, so it's going to more or less suck them in, just like the wizard's black hole. It's, from what I've seen so far, it's very effective, does a great deal of damage, but I'm also going to be strengthening that effect with the strong arm bracers. I'm hoping that this is also going to affect, I hope that it's considered a knockback for that 30% increased damage. And eventually, I would like to be able to replace my Hellfire Amulet with the S of Johan. Okay, next, I do like my Command Skeletons. I like having that extra damage there. Some folks would take another curse or other abilities, but I like having those guys there. They do quite a significant amount of damage, and also the ability to have them target something when you may not necessarily be able to, adds that extra level of DPS. And not only that, but they also get aggro. So that means they're going to be getting chomped on as well, which can take a little bit of that off of you, which is nice. I am using Decrepify. The Decrepify is a slow. It reduces the enemy's movement, speed, and damage done. So that means they're going to do less damage to me, and they're going to slow them. And also, as Borrowed Time Rune will gain cooldown reduction for every enemy that is cursed. So anything that's within that AoE is going to reduce the downtime of my Army of the Dead. Not to mention, but by also using my Bane of the Trapped, I am hoping that that's going to increase my damage against them that much more. That's the idea behind that. Okay, lastly is I'm taking bone armor, rip bones from nearby enemies, dealing damage, and creating armor that reduces damage taken per enemy hit. So what's that's doing? It's doing literally what it says. It rips the bones out of the enemies, and you do see this. This is part of the animation, but it applies it to you, so it actually changes how you look. It evolves how you look. It places that armor on you. It's kind of like Akarat's Champion, Vengeance, and all that whatnot. Changes your appearance. Some people don't like it. I actually do. I think you look really badass with a set of bone armor. So that's another reason why I took it. But I also took Dislocation, again, to kind of focus on that Bane of the Trapped. Enemies are also stunned. I'm already in the middle of them. I'm summoning my armor. I don't want them hitting me, so I'm just going to go ahead and stun them as well. That's the whole idea behind that. For the passives, I chose Draw Life as my first one. I was originally going to choose Stand Alone, but then after reading this again, increases armor by 100%, reduced 10% for each active minion. Well, I like having my minions out. So having seven of them there, that kind of hurts. So I went ahead and chose Draw Life, which increases my health regen by 10% for each enemy within 20 yards. Again, I'm right in the middle of them all, so they should be also helping me in that regard as well. Grizzly Tribute. You are healed for 10% of your life on hit when one of your minions hits an enemy. Yay! I've already talked about Eternal Torment. And Swift Harvesting increases the attack speed of Bone Spikes and Siphon Blood and Grim Scythe by 15%. So I'm going to be swinging that Summoned Scythe that much faster. Okay, I will show you how this works in action, but it kind of leads into what I'm going to be talking about next. You may or may not know, there are new zones. There are two new zones within Act 2, the Shrouded Moors and the Temple of the Firstborn. Now, how badass does that sound? Right off the bat, the Shrouded Moors looks pretty cool. You got these monoliths all along the side as soon as you log in there, and it looks really neat. There we go with that bone armor. That's what it looks like. Check that out. See, will it actually show me that now? You can barely see my head there. It almost looks like a type of power armor from Fallout. Got these new enemies here. They look like werewolves. Let's take a look around. Got all these monuments. Really neat. The candles, they give you that eerie dark feeling. Like that. I've seen these places too. One of the other things I have in the cube is the Ring of the Zodiac as well as the Furnace. You know, again, my whole purpose is to make sure I get those elites down as fast as I can. And the Ring of the Zodiac, as you will know, also helps with the cooldown of Army of the Dead.
Consumes you.
Looks really nice. These are mean looking monsters. As of right now, we don't have a whole lot of story or lore behind these two locations or what the significance is of them. I would love to know, especially that Temple of the Firstborn. That just sounds neat. I don't know if you've ever heard of a game called Jericho. That's what it reminds me of, because it's all about the Firstborn, the first creation of God, and how it was innately evil. And that was a pretty good game. Way off.
Thank you. Have a very nice time.
Can't find your way, just go ahead and look for treasure chests. They light up the way. Not much monster density in here at all. Stop there. 1.3 trillion. Yeah, I guess this is it. It's just a clear one level. Alright. Fair enough. Assuming that the Army of the Dead will have a better animation a little bit later on. Right now I think the only ones that has a decent animation is Without a Rune.
Someone's on that hill.
What's this? Victim. Poor bastard. Fancy breakables. Creepy though, you had all the heads, urns, blood in them, all going towards that centerpiece. Dark.
Right.
So you get an idea as to what to expect from here. There's an area that I want to make sure is not doesn't lead me to a secondary area or not up here and down here. So I'm going to go check that out, possibly up here. Yeah, I'm going to go check it out. So
fast forward.
Okay, so this takes me to the excavation. And if you're wondering, that PH, if you haven't figured it out already, means placeholder. Alright, so this doesn't look creepy at all. Got the same candles in a cave type of environment. A very familiar cave. What is this? The dude that was helping me out, well, not really helping me out, but that was that I was leading. Yeah, he died quickly. Where'd he go? Wait. Wait, did he just get exploded? Huh. Sucks. Okay, so this looks like the Temple of the Firstborn, I wanna say. It's got that gothic look to it, but this underground cathedral. Look at that. Some creepy statues of them holding a skull with a spine. Other side. Whoa. So I wonder if we're going to see some type of greater evil, something that's even darker and more sinister than even Diablo and the Primevals. Because that would be really cool, you know? I mean, even if they take the story somewhere like they did with WoW, where, you know, all this time we thought we were fighting, you know, Sargeras and the demons, and then it turns out, oh no, there's more. There's also the Void Lords, and then, or the Old Gods, and then the Void Lords. So I wonder if they're going to be doing something like that. I mean, look at them. It kind of looks like the Faceless Ones, or Cthulhu, or something like that. The octopus head. So it really makes me wonder. I mean, this is pretty sinister. I mean, these guys are so evil and fucked up that they're going to be taking zombies and hanging them up on the wall. Some of these bad guys look pretty systematic, disciple. They're considered demons. Interesting.
Come to me.
Skulls in their chest that are ripped apart in half. The dudes that look like cancerous. Terribly reminds me of something like out of Warhammer 40K. Alright, let's see how bad this is gonna go.
Thank you.
terrible. Guess that Tormenting Theory is supposed to have some set stuff by now, but that's just making excuses. How much damage I got? 900,000? Almost. Find a bad guy. Very dark, very sinister. Bugs. Not creepy at all. This is almost how I would expect Diablo's cathedral in hell from Diablo 2 would look. I mean, this is kind of how I would expect it to look. Gothic, just something absolutely terrifying.
Weakness consumes you.
Yep, that was cool. Killing them all also triggered the blood portal thingy. Still got a lot of area over there I didn't cover. Should I go back? I'll do it some other time. Alright. Dude, this is a Temple of the Firstborn level 2. Again, I really like the idea of something called the Firstborn. Firstborn from what? That's what I really want to know. Clearly, this is ancient. Gothic, cathedral, down, underground. Place of satanic worship. Red and glowy and creepy. There's murder room. Really? Ain't gonna be my murder. Who's this guy? Hey, there's that guy. I thought he got blown up. Turns into this. Didian, Lord of Envy. Huh. Ugly. That. Interesting. All right. I'm assuming we're going to be getting much more story at some point in time, because clearly this place has some lore somewhere. You know, something along the way, we're probably going to be getting something. There's got to be books, even if we just get it in that form. But, I'm kind of glad that he got a chance to die like this so that we can get a decent look at it. It's hard to really see, but almost reminds me of Mephisto. Huh. Mephisto was the oldest. I wonder if they're gonna bring back Mephisto. Well, that would be cool. I don't know. What do you guys think? All right. Well, that's it for this video. In this video, I showed you my melee build. Clearly, it needs some work. I definitely need to put out some more damage. I'm not sure what I would change just yet, whether I'm gonna change to get rid of my pets, or change out my Death Nova for something else that I haven't tried yet. Maybe Revive, or Corpse Lance, or Corpse Explosion, something along those lines. I definitely need some work. I definitely need to go back and try to tinker some more. Not being able to finish off those cursed chests was a little bit of a wake-up call, but as you saw, I was in no danger of dying. I was actually doing some pretty good damage to enemies like Guardians and whatnot, so I'd be curious to see how this holds up in later griffs, but again, without set bonuses and whatnot. Now, I know it's possible to do griffs and whatnot without those set bonuses, but, you know, Set bonuses always make it a little bit easier. All right. Again, if there's anything that specific that you would like me to test and share with you all, please post that in the comment section below. If you like this video, please throw it a like and subscribe for more as I continue the Necromancer beta series. All right. Until next time, Horseman out.